Michael Jordan before I turn on the...
Yeah, how many times Michael Jordan lost? Do you know, Tino? Anybody I know don't. How many times Michael Jordan lost?
Many he times.
Lost well, what's your point? I don't get it. Like,
I mean, this is sport.
Yeah.
Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. I mean, you know, we don't know what's going to happen, even with Pacquiao against Mayweather. You know, Pacquiao might have diarrhea that night.
Yeah. I think
you know what I mean? Like, Floyd might catch a cold. People miss work because of cold.
The flu, yeah.
You know what I mean?
So what you're saying is...
It's not about who wins and who loses. I mean, I think Floyd's a marketing genius for, you know, going into that. And you know, I give Floyd all the respect because, you know, after he said, you know, I never lost, I'm undefeated, I'm the greatest ever, he hasn't lost.
Yeah.
You know, you can argue that, you know, Floyd cherry picks his opponents, but I mean, it doesn't matter. At the end of the day, you sign the contract, you're in the ring, you're fighting in front of, like, how many people watch?
Millions of
fans, but live, you're fighting in front
thousands.
Of 50, I don't know, like
family,
50,
friends,
50,000 people. I don't know, like, I'm just throwing crazy
fans.
Numbers, but you know, sparring is a lot easier than actually fighting in front of all these people, because sparring is sparring, you know? So, I mean, you can't judge a fighter based on one fight. You know, I don't... You know, Pacquiao got knocked out by Marquez, which is like a second left on the, what, sixth or seventh round? But Pacquiao, being a real fighter, he tried to squeeze in a couple more punches. That's what happened. He got caught with the overhand right to the jaw. I mean, that punch, I mean, you know, I don't know if anyone can recover from that. You know?
Do you think it's not fair?
Not to mention, Pacquiao gave Marquez four fights, which is his toughest opponent. So, I mean, I call Pacquiao people's champ.
Yeah.
For sure.
Do you think it's not fair that, you know, after, let's say, a fighter gets one loss, they already write him off and they say he sucks and all this?
That's the nature of the sport.
Life is not fair. Boxing is definitely not fair. I think Jim Lampley said that boxing in some way is a pain of life. I don't know if he knows what he's talking about, but at the same time, I think he's money on that.
Why do you say...
Boxing is definitely not fair. Because, you know, there should be fighters who's getting paid as much as Floyd Mayweather, but, you know, nobody knows they exist. Kovalev, like, for example.
Basically, everybody wants to fight with Floyd because it's a payday.
It's a payday. That's all there is to it.
It's a payday. It's a sport. If you're fighting Floyd, you're at the top of your...
Then after that, Robert Guerrero, yeah, for example, I mean, people are writing him off already because he lost to Floyd, but, you know, his skill level doesn't, you know, vanish all of a sudden after Mayweather.
Nobody understands that.
He's the best fighter in the world.
Nobody understands that he jumped like 2 or 3 weight classes to fight him.
Yeah, he was a beast in 135. So was Floyd, though.
No, I'm just saying, nobody's going to avoid that payday. I keep going back to money. People fighting at this level about
Floyd Mayweather said the best. If he gets knocked out and if he's all fucked up, who's going to visit him in the hospital? All these fans?
No.
No.
Nobody's going to...
He's by himself. At the end of the day, with his money.
I was seeing
it's Jim Lampley, Max Kellerman, Jim Gray, Roy Jones, and I.
Yeah,
and
I think Roy Jones is appropriate because it's appropriate because that was the fall of Roy Jones when he fought. So you'll see the fall of Mayweather. You know what I'm saying? So it's appropriate that it's that.
So you think Mayweather's gonna get knocked out?
I don't see him getting knocked out. I see him losing. I'm just saying, and my thing is, and it's sort of unfortunate because money-wise, he wins anyway. But you know how fans...
Yeah, there's no loser in this fight.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, loser is going to be whoever... I mean, Pacquiao, if Pacquiao loses, Pacquiao fans are going to feel like they're losers.
Yeah.
Or
yeah,
Mayweather loses, Mayweather fans are going to feel
like... But as far as the boxing, there's no loser.
But in terms of Pacquiao, Mayweather, if you're getting paid $80 million and you're getting paid $120 million,
there's no losers.
Pacquiao has a lot of pressure, though, because, I mean, he's not only a star in the Philippines. That guy is a global icon.
But do you think people are going to all of a sudden think Pacquiao's garbage because he lost to Mayweather?
Yeah.
The casual fans, yes. The ones that see a fight once every 2-3 years, or maybe the ones that are just going to see this fight,
then,
yeah.
But then again, their life don't affect Pacquiao.
Yeah. My whole thing is fans,
going back to what I said earlier about I don't care who wins this. Whoever wins, that doesn't affect my life. at the end of the day, I enjoy the fight. I'm just glad that they're fighting. And you know, next day, May 3rd, I'll go back to my normal life.
Yeah. But fans, you know, are not loyal. Really, fans are not loyal at all. So
exactly.
Yeah. So loyal. I'm gonna tell you what happens. Nobody will give a shit about if Mayweather loses. Nobody will give a shit about that last fight.
Maybe for a week.
Yeah. It'll go and they forgive and they forget. They'll talk about it for about a week, maybe two.
Just like Seahawks and the Patriots.
Exactly.
People talk about that for a week because of the way Seahawks lost. But you know what? Everyone went back to their own life. You know what I mean?
At the end of the day, it's entertainment. It's only entertainment.
Yeah, we're fans.
Yeah.
What do you think about fans saying that the fight is 5 years too late?
It's bullshit.
You're getting it anyway.
Yeah, I mean, they have a point. Yeah. I mean, I wish the fight was made 5-6 years ago, but you know what?
Life's not fair.
What the hell are you going to do about it?
I think it's
not,
bullshit.
It's not,
you're not making the match.
Yeah, you're not in control. They're in control.
I think it's bullshit because, honestly, a fight like that, of that caliber, is timeless. It's a fight with no expiration date.
They said that about Ali and Foreman before they fought. You know, if it was Ali who fought Sonny Liston, it would be an easy win.
Yeah.
But it's too late. Guess what? Everyone watched that fight.
So. Yeah.
And you know, Ali knocked him out. So, I mean, we don't know what's going to happen. Like I said, I'm just going to enjoy this ride until May 2nd. And when the fight ends, you know, I'm going to go back to my
normal life.
And I'll wait for Canelo versus Curtin.
Yeah.
And then I'll wait for the next big fight.
I'm just waiting for that page in boxing to turn so we can go to the next.
Are you happy with the commentators who's going to be commentating the fight?
Cares if I'm happy or not. I'm just gonna be watching anyway. Yeah. If they can charge, you know, I'll say it like this. They can charge $500. I know I'll pay for it. So it doesn't matter. You know, they can pick a homeless guy to be a commentator. I'm okay.
We're not watching the commentators.
You know, I mean, it's not about commentators. Yeah. You know, I enjoy Max Kellerman and Jim Lampley and all and Roy Jones. I'm a big fan. I mean, who doesn't like Roy Jones, right? But guess what? When the fight starts, they're irrelevant. So May 2nd, let's just enjoy this ride and let's enjoy the fight instead of fighting over who's going to win the fight.
Yeah, we'll recap this.
That is not that important at the end of the day. It's about enjoying the fight.
I just think, I hope the fight lives up to its expectations. Yeah.
And I think that depends on Mayweather.
Why is that?
Pacquiao's going to do his thing. He's going to come to fight.
I don't want no technicalities. No stupid shit like that. Let's fight, have a good fight. And people paying $500, $600, thousands of dollars for these tickets. People paying fucking $500 for pay-per-view, all this dumbass shit. Man. Give us a good fight. That's all I ask.
Man, I was looking at a resale place for tickets, like a ticket broker. They don't even have the tickets out already, but you know how they reserve them? So when they get them,
they're upset. StubHub is ridiculous.
$10,000 for fucking cheap seats, bro.
Yeah.
I know, this is the fight of the century.
Well, think about it, yeah.
They say they're comparing this to Tyson versus Lewis, but it's a little different because that's after Tyson went to jail.
Yeah.
You know, so...
after the prime.
And they're going to talk about Mayweather and Pacquiao, they're both old, but I mean, come on, they both look great.
I think the comparison comes because we've seen it, like, in boxing history. I mean, if you go back to, like, Hagler versus Leonard, you know, how long... That fight should have happened, like, earlier in their careers, and it happened, like, you know... Leonard retired twice before he even took that fight. Yeah. You know what I mean?
But it wasn't going to happen. In any great boxer.
Well, not to mention Hagler, in my opinion, and you know, I don't know if Sugar Ray Leonard is going to watch this. I think Hagler kind of won the fight, but that's at that time, people thought Leonard was done. So, I mean, you know, it is what it is. I mean, same thing with Ali and Foreman.
But you know, the thing with these fights is that they need to happen because... These fights close an era of boxing.
It's really what it is. Yeah. I think it's like a end of Mayweather-Pacquiao era.
Turning the chapter to the next generation.
I'm ready for that.